Hey there, students. If you clicked on this video, I assume you want to know the difference between deductive and inductive reasoning. So let me tell you. Now, first of all, deductive reasoning has been around a lot longer. Goes all the way back to Aristotle. Deductive reasoning is a method of reasoning by which you start with a premise and you go to another premise, and these premises lead you to a conclusion, all right? And if you've done this right and logically and all that, then you have arrived at something that is certain, a certain conclusion, meaning not just a certain conclusion, but a conclusion that we can be certain of. Now, then there is inductive reasoning. And inductive reasoning, fast forward about 2,000 years, and we go to Sir Francis Bacon, a 17th century English natural philosopher, which is what they called scientists back in the day. And inductive reasoning, instead of starting with a general premise, moving on to a particular premise, and then getting to an answer that way, Sir Francis Bacon said that the way we arrive at truth is to make repeated observations. And then, out of those repeated observations, we generalize these repeatedly observed phenomena into a probable conclusion. That's the very simple version. Now, he outlined this in his Novum Organum in 1620, which means new method. Now, keep in mind, new method, as in a new method, the old method's been around for like 2,000 years. So what you have to keep in mind here is when Bacon is bringing forward this inductive reasoning, that he is challenging Aristotle, which is something that's really kind of distinctive about the scientific revolution, is this willingness to challenge ancient authorities that people had not done for about 2,000 years. When you think about these ancient authorities like Aristotle, that they were still towering very high. And Aristotle's still a big deal today, but he's certainly not the foundation for physical science or anything like that. The simplest way we can compare inductive and deductive reasoning is to look at deductive reasoning as top-down, where we start with a generalization and it leads us to a specific instance, all right, that conclusion is very specific, whereas inductive reasoning is bottom-up.
You said bottom!
Where we start with a number of specific instances and that leads us to make a generalization. Now, of course, as in anything philosophical or scientific, that many experts will say that this is an oversimplification, but at the same time, it does help. By the way, shout out to Dr. Carl Carpenter, my first principal and the first guy ever to talk to me about inductive and deductive reasoning. And so with deductive reasoning, conclusions are drawn from premises. You start with premises. Top-down logic again. Now, as far as these premises, the most classic example of a premise is when Aristotle says, first of all men are mortal. We start with a general premise. And then we look at a specific situation. Socrates is a man. Therefore, Socrates is mortal. Going from general to specific. I've got a video on Rene Descartes, who was a philosopher of the scientific revolution. And Descartes is most famous for saying, cogito ergo sum, I think, therefore I am. Now, cogito ergo sum is actually a statement of deductive reasoning. Because what Descartes did is he came to the conclusion, he's trying to figure out if he exists, all right? This guy, he went real deep. Descartes says, first of all, what thinks must exist, all right? That something that thinks can only do that if they exist. Two, I am thinking. Therefore, or in Latin, ergo, I exist. I think, therefore, I am. Deductive reasoning. Then we bring in our friend Blake, 10th place at the National FFA Convention. We're really proud of that guy. Now, starting with premises, first of all, good students pass exams. Second, Blake is a good student. Third, Blake will pass his exam. Blake better pass his exam, all right? But if Blake does not pass his exam, then what I would need to do is I would have to go back and check my premises, that at least one of those premises must be wrong if the conclusion is false. Either one, Blake is not a good student, or two, maybe not every good student passes exams. So maybe I came to a false conclusion. So this is one of those things that the conclusion can kind of stand until you realize, wait, that's false. And then I go back to the premises, I figure out which one was false, and if my logic didn't add up or something like that. Deductive reasoning. So as far as inductive reasoning, we draw conclusions from observations. So we start with observations. This is what we call in science and philosophy empiricism, which is a big deal during the scientific revolution and the Enlightenment. And this is really about connecting the dots. And the more data we have, the greater the probability of the conclusion being true. So for example, if we were to look at these three dots, what do you see? Dramatic pause. Did you see a triangle? Well, it could be a triangle, but then again, it could also be a circle. See? 3 points on a circle, 3 points on a triangle. Don't you feel stupid now if you saw the triangle? Well, actually, the thing is, though, we don't know what it is. It could be a triangle. So the thing is, when we get more data, then this is looking more like a triangle. Then again, it could be something else. But we see that, okay, triangle fits here, and a circle does not fit here. So we know that that is not a circle. So the more data, the closer we are to certainty, although we don't quite get there, which is what David Hume, the skeptical Scotsman, has to say about the problem of induction. That really, when it comes down to it, induction cannot ever lead us to certain knowledge because it presupposes that things will stay the way they always have been. So for example, if I were to say the sun always rises in the east, what I'm really saying is there is a very high probability that the sun will rise in the east, that it always does, because we have always seen it that way. But are we certain that the sun will rise in the east tomorrow? Okay, think about your ex-boyfriend or ex-girlfriend or something like that. And it's like, well, this person loves me. Well, you know, you believe that because that's been true, but is it always true? Does it remain true? Usually it does not. The one constant we can count on is change. Another thing that's used often is when somebody says all swans are white. What you're really saying is all swans that I've seen are white. And not all swans, because I have not seen all swans, and therefore I can't make that judgment. Now keep in mind that certainty is not even the goal of inductive reasoning, because while deductive reasoning aims to arrive at certainty, inductive reasoning is only a function of probability and saying that we can infer that this is true, that there is a high probability that this is true, not that we can ever be 100% certain of anything, because science changes. It evolves over time. You know, we don't base our physics on Aristotle anymore. So when it comes down to it, the scientific method is a repeated process of induction and deduction. It's not that one of these reasoning forms is better than the other. They're different. So that's about it. Hopefully you learned something. If you did, please subscribe. Visit my website, tomritchey.net, social media, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all of that good stuff. I'll be back soon with some more lectures in history and philosophy and all kinds of other good stuff. Until next time.